Well, hello there guys, my name is mr.great and today I will be reviewing the low range smartphone from the Motorola, which is Moto E4. It has an elder brother which is a Moto E4 Plus. We will discuss the difference of between the both in a while, so let's begin. Moto E4 was released on the June of this year and is priced at 9,000 rupees. This budget smartphone has 5-inch IPS LCD display with protection ensured by Corning Gorilla Glass 3, which is a rather odd for Motorola to use the previous generation of Gorilla Glass when the Gorilla Glass 4 is already available. One thing to note here is that the display of the phone is HD and it is not full HD, which is a flaw as other phones such as Redmi Note 4 offers full HD display in the same price range. Apart from that, the phone has standard Motorola design along with the addition of fingerprint sensor at the front, along with the circular button on the right, and the primary mic along with the micro USB port is placed at the bottom of the phone, whereas 3.5mm audio jack is at the top. Overall, the quality and the finish of the phone looks pretty premium for the budget range phone and has a nice finish to it. Still having a plastic body, but the back panel is of metal, but still it's prone to scratches and hence it is advised to go with a protective cover with this one. The weight of the phone is around 150 grams, so attaching a cover won't make it heavy and will also provide protection. The 5-inch screen of the Moto E4 is HD, meaning it fully supports the resolution up to 720x1280 with the 294 pixel per inch, which doesn't make it great, but it is good for a budget range smartphone as the viewing angle and the colors are pretty decent. Unlike all standard Motorola phones, the Moto E4 has an IPS LCD screen, meaning that it is good, but it is not better than the AMOLED screen that Samsung and some other smartphone makers usually use in their smartphone. The phone runs on the Android 7.1.1 Nougat right out of the box and has a good chance of getting an Android O update in the coming months. The phone houses a 2800 mAh battery, which is removable by removing the back panel. The battery capacity given by Motorola in this phone is quite low, even for this price range. Also, the newly released Moto E4 Plus has a much larger 5000 mAh capacity battery, which costs just 1000 more than the Moto E4. The phone does not support fast charging or wireless charging, which makes battery a major downfall. Since the smartphone makers such as Xiaomi are offering 4100 mAh of better battery capacity and the Redmi Note 4 is just a slight bump in the price. I am not a Redmi fan, but obviously Moto should see what's in the competition. Coming to the performance. In terms of the processing power of the phone houses a MediaTek MT6737 processor, comprises of 4 cores clocked at 1.3 GHz. The phone with coupled with 2 GB of RAM and 16 GB of storage, the processor performed very well as I did not find any single lag during the usage of the phone. Also, the phone runs on a stock UI version of the Android, so it is completely light on the hardware and in turn RAM is more available for the user. Though in terms of gaming, we would not suggest this device for as a gaming material as though it is a budget phone, but it was able to play some light games such as Subway Surfer Temple Run without any issues. The phone heated on some big games such as GTA and performance wasn't that good. Also, if you feel like 16 GB storage is not enough, then don't worry, the Moto E4 supports an expandable storage up to 128 GB via SD card. The camera is one of the best things that I like about this smartphone. Moto E4 comes with 8MP of rear camera with f2.2 aperture with LED flash and has a front camera of 5MP with same f2.2 aperture along with LED flash. The camera shots were quite better than what I expected from the Moto E4. Moto E4 performed really well in the camera department. The color reproduction and the saturation was really good and even the front camera performed really well instead of having a 5MP lens. The front and back LED flash were quite good add-on at the night time. Moto E4 is able to record HD videos at 30 frames per second, but there is no 4K recording as expected from a budget range smartphone. The next big thing about the Moto E4 is probably its speakers that are placed at the back panel of the phone. During the usage of the phone and watching movies, the finger spreads around the speaker at the back panel instead of completely covering it. The speakers was really loud and the sound quality was quite audible and crystal clear. The speakers was really superb and performed above expectations. Here you can listen yourself.
Get up,
As always, Moto E4 comes with the standard Moto features and gestures that can be turned on from the options available in dedicated Moto app, which is a pre-installed app in all the Moto phones. These features include the ambient screen that lights up in a minimal way, showing only notification in black and white, thus conserving battery life. Also, if you pick up the phone or flick it, it shows Moto clock along with some other smaller icon for any notification you have. You have also an option to use your fingerprint sensors as a standard navigation bar. Turning this on would disable your standard on-screen navigation buttons and enable various gestures that you can use in combination with your fingerprint to navigate around the phone, such as tap fingerprint to go to home button or swipe fingerprint to open recents and swipe left to go back and all that. Apart from some low range hardware such as MediaTek processor and only 2 gigs of RAM, the Moto E4 does stand out in the crowd with its bombastic speakers, stock Nougat user interface and premium metallic finish, and it has an exceptionally beautiful camera. Now let us talk about the difference between Moto E4 and Moto E4 Plus. So in the design, there is no much difference in the design of Moto E4 and Moto E4 Plus. Coming on the processor and RAM, both the smartphones are powered with MediaTek MT6737 quad-core SoC clocked with 1.3 GHz. And all that features are same, but the Moto E4 Plus comes with 3 gigs of RAM and Moto E4 has 2 gigs of RAM. So there is difference in RAM and there is difference in storage. The Moto E4 Plus comes with 32 gigs of storage and Moto E4 comes with 16 gigs of storage. Now there is also difference between camera. The Moto E4 Plus comes with a larger sensor. The smartphone has 13 megapixel rear camera and dual tone LED flash. Other features such as HD recording are same as the Moto E4. Now coming on the battery of Moto E4 Plus is 5000 mAh battery and the battery of Moto E4 is 2800 mAh. So there is a much difference between battery as compared to the prices of both the smartphones, but still the 5000 mAh battery is obviously good and I would suggest you to go for Moto E4 Plus by investing a little amount of money as compared to Moto E4. It's really a great deal breaker as the sibling of the smartphone has really great battery in such a lower price range. All of the features are same. The Moto E4 comes in 9000 rupees and the Moto E4 Plus comes in 10000 rupees. So you should definitely go for Moto E4 Plus in my opinion as compared to Moto E4. But you are on a strict budget of 9000 rupees only, then you can go for Moto E4. In the end, Moto E4 is a great smartphone with awesome design and I will suggest you to go for it if you have a strict budget of 9000. There are many phones such as Redmi Note 4, 2GB RAM and 32 gigs of storage comes in 9000 rupees. You can also see that. I'm not a Redmi fan and not recommending this. Thanks guys, this is all my review on the Moto E4. Thanks for watching this video. Don't forget to like, don't forget to hit subscribe. Always feel great guys. This is Mr. Great signing off. Jai Hind. अक्षय और एक ये है गौरव. तो फाइनली जो भी जीता है जो भी मैंने देखा नहीं कैमरा में उस वक्त रिकॉर्डिंग करते हुए किसी और ध्यान में लग गया था. आप लोगों ने देखा होगा तो बता देना कौन जीता.
नशे करने का यही सलाह होता है.
राउंड टू केओ किसका हुआ ये सब बता देना. दिस इज मिस्टर
ग्रेट
साइनिंग ऑफ. जय हिंद.
राउंड वन फाइट. राउंड टू फाइट.
राउंड टू.
Perfect. Double KO. Final round.
मार दे खींच के मार दे.